Hallo, I'm Bas Cornelissen, but zeg maar Bas.
Yeah, that joke doesn't work in English.
But there's a new video here. Yeah, the first one since...
Yeah, 10 months.
But yeah, a new video. And I know, if I had more time, I would make more videos.
Did you guys hear that? That was a conditional phrase.
If I had more time, I would make more videos.
I think I just got a good idea.
Conditional sentence is a sentence with the word if in it. You can use it to explain that something is likely gonna happen, or not likely, or it is not gonna happen at all. For example, if I leave at 6, I will catch the train. You can see that this is a very simple form. And this is the type 1, and there are 3 types which I'm gonna handle all in this video. So the first type is the one which I just used, and you can use that to tell that something is likely gonna happen. It's just the simple present, I leave on time, then I will catch the train. And it is just the will future form, so will catch, will make, will eat. Just very simple. Then there's the second type. And the second type is almost the same as the first type. But instead of the simple present, use the simple past. So if I leave on time, becomes if I left on time. And on the other side, will changes in would. So, if I left on time, I would catch the train. Yeah, but I'm probably not gonna leave on time, so I'm probably not gonna catch the train. That's what I'm saying with this phrase. Then there's the third type. The third type we use when we are not gonna catch the train at all. So, in this case, we use the past perfect in the first bit. So, if I had left on time, I would have catched that train. So, instead of would of will, it now is would have. And then there's a past participle behind that. Now we know those 3 forms, we know the basics of how to use the conditional phrases. But there's a bit more variation in that, however. So, yeah, and that could make some students struggle. But don't worry, I'll explain. First of all, we can place the if part of the sentence at the end. But as you can see, that doesn't really change anything, so for the sake of the video, I'll keep it on the left. Of course, we can also add the word not to the phrase. And yeah, that is pretty straightforward. We can also change would from type 2 and 3 into could and might. Occasionally, may, must and should fit as well. And finally, we can also use some other tenses in our phrases. But because there are so many possibilities here, I can't explain them all in this video. So yeah, if I had time, I may make another video about that. But as you can hear from me using type 2, it probably won't happen. So in short, there are 3 types of conditional phrases. The first 2 types have a simple present or simple past, followed by a comma, after which we use will or would and infinitive to say that something will likely or unlikely happen. The third type uses a past perfect, followed by a would have and a past participle. Then we can change would, the sentence order, the tense, or we can add not to the sentence. That's it! Now you know how to use conditional phrases, and now you can impress your friends with it, so go do that. I see you around. Goodbye. That's it.